Another study, tablet manufacturing process by dry granulation. In case of the dry granulation, first of all, API and excipients. In suitable quantity are dispensed. After the dispensing process, the API and intragranular excipient they undergo mixing process. Or it is called as a dry mixing process. So what is intragranular excipient? So the excipient that are added in the granules, they are called as the intragranular excipients. So these excipients and API are part of the granules, because we add some of the excipients extragranularly. After dry mixing process, the material undergo roller compactor to prepare slugs. So these slugs are prepared under roller compactor. Here the annotations are viewable on desktop computer or desktop site of your mobile devices. After that, these slugs, they undergo milling and crushing to prepare required size of the granules. So the granule size may be about 16 mass to 30 mass, or any other suitable size of the sieve can be selected depending upon the requirement of the product. These granules undergo the mixing process with extragranular excipient. Mixing with extragranular excipient. So the extragranular excipients are those excipients that we add after granulation. So they are not the part of the granules. They may be extragranular diluent or disintegrating agent or any other suitable material. After that, they undergo the lubrication. With lubricating agent. So the lubricating agent such as magnesium stearate or calcium stearate or stearic acid, or depending upon the requirement of the product, any other suitable lubricating agent can be utilized. After that, this material is called as a ready to compress material. This material is ready to compress material. After that, this material undergo compression to prepare tablet of the required size. So this is the process of the dry granulation. So the difference with the wet granulation is that here there is no wet granulation. There is a completely dry process. No use of the granulating liquid. So the drying step is omitted. So that this process is cost effective. Now let us revise the process. First of all, the API and excipients are dispensed. And the API and intragranular excipients, they undergo the dry mixing process. After the dry mixing, the material is undergo the roller compactor to prepare slugs. These slugs, they are undergo the milling and crushing to prepare the required size of the granules. These granules are mixed with the extragranular excipients. After that, it is lubricated with the lubricating agent. After that, this material is ready to compress material, and it undergoes the compression process to prepare final tablet. So this was about the tablet manufacturing process by dry granulation.